So here I have two curves, okay, F1 and F2, and those are meant to be as taken in two different times. And here I'm just looking at this point x0, and just so you understand, this is the value at, if you will, time 2, this is the value at time 1, and that's true for all of these. And the question is, how much does the curve move? So what I have to do is, I want to find this displacement at x0, all right? So do it as follows. So here's how we do. We initialize, since this is iterative, we have to initialize. We'll first start by assuming that our displacement was 0. That is, u and v are all zeros everywhere. That's great. That makes the warp really, really fast. I don't do anything. It's the original picture. Now I have to estimate the next one, d1, by figuring out what the new displacement is. That's what this new little delta d is going to be. So how do I do that? Well, I have to compute these tangents, and you can see the tangents are right there, okay? And what I do is, based upon that tangent, come down here, it says, oh, okay, if this thing were actually a plane, this amount, that's my d hat. That's the amount I have to displace over in order to line up these points. That's assuming this thing were a plane. And if it really were a plane, that would be the amount that I would have to move. So let me do that displacement, and I end up there. So now I've got my d1, which was just d0 plus my new estimate. And guess what? I have to do it again. So now I take a look and say, ah, I have to move this amount. So I add that to my d, and I move it that much. And guess what? I do it again. Estimate tiny little d hat this time, and voila, it turns out that F1 of x minus d3 is almost exactly F2 at this point, okay? That's the iterative refinement. And the only thing that it takes in order to do this iterative Lucas and Conati beyond the regular one is this warping step. Given some UV that you've computed between one image and the next, take that first image, warp it through that flow field, and now you'll have almost the second image, and you just apply it over again.